nature deficit disorder. We're about to hear what that is and find out the best places in America to raise an outdoor kid. Jonathan Dorn is editor-in-chief of Backpacker Magazine, and he is back with us this morning. Good to see you again.
Morning, Harry.
So would you call it nature deficit disorder, which is what exactly?
Well, as you know, it's not an official medical condition, but it's a term that was popularized by Richard Louv, the author of Last Child in the Woods, and it's used to describe this idea that the alarming increase that we've seen in childhood obesity and attention deficit disorder over the last quarter century is related to the fact that for the first time in our history, most of our kids are growing up without a real connection to nature.
Right. And they're growing, most of them are growing up in cities.
And they are, and they're not getting it through work, through play, through outdoor education.
Yeah.
And as a result, one in five kids now in the U.S. is considered overweight by the CDC.
Wow, which is an epidemic. Let's talk about the best cities in the country to raise an outdoor kid. And a place that I used to live, it makes all the sense of the world to me, is Boulder.
And that's where I live, too, now. I'm a lucky guy. More than 250 days a year of sun, an incredible infrastructure in the city. One thing I love about it is that they plow the bike paths, and there's 105 miles of bike paths before they plow the roads.
It really is. It's really the bike paths there on the streets are as much as part of the traffic pattern as any place in the country. Unlike many places, including New York City, which is slowly starting to catch up. Right behind Boulder is Jackson, Wyoming.
Jackson, if the kids like the zoo, this is like living in the zoo, because Jackson is right next door to Grand Teton National Park in Yellowstone. Bears, moose, elk, everything you could possibly want, plus world-class skiing. And like a lot of these top cities, really good education, high test scores, a sound infrastructure in the schools for ecology curriculums and the like.
Yeah, it really, they marry the two, the outdoors and the education. Right behind, then you have Durango, which is another just garden spot. What a gorgeous, gorgeous place.
It's in the Four Corners region. We partnered in this study with the Outdoor Foundation and looked at 38 different data categories. And Durango, like these other towns, scored very high, both in terms of how close it is to great wilderness and how livable it is in terms of education and lifestyle.
Wow. Flagstaff up in northern Arizona, not so far from the Grand Canyon. You're giving me a bad case of Western homesickness today.
Flagstaff is great both because it's the gateway to the Grand Canyon and kids there actually work as junior rangers in the park during the summer.
Cool.
But also Flagstaff schools have built in an ecology curriculum for sixth graders. They spend a week in the field learning.
Doesn't that look great? Are you just ready to go right now? You have a whole list, but rounding out our top group is Juneau, which is another just awesome place.
Right, and you've taken your kids to the Juneau area, so you know that you've got glaciers, you've got bears, you've got fly fishing. 40 million acres of pristine wilderness surround the Juneau area.
We went out kayaking out on Glacier Bay one morning just to sort of hang out and be around where the whales were. Dude.
And one thing that maybe gets overlooked is that there's a benefit not only for the kids in getting them out, but there's a benefit for the parents too. I suspect that the bonding experience that you had with your kids while you were out there participating with them was one of the most memorable experiences of your life.
You got that right. And then I think the other thing is very quickly, if you live in an urban setting, how do you get your kids to appreciate this stuff?
There are a lot of groups, even in New York City, whether it's a retail store like REI or a hiking or climbing club, that do weekly clinics that take kids out on trips.
Got to do it. Jonathan Dorn, thanks so much. Always a pleasure to see you.
Thanks, Eric.
This guy is one of the great lives ever. See the entire list of these cities. Go to our website, earlyshow.cbsnews.com.